We want to find the value of the Riemann sum given here for f of x equals 2 raised to the power of x plus 10 using the partitions p equals 0, 2, 5, and 7, where c sub k, the input into the function, is the left endpoint of each partition. So because our function is non-negative over this interval, we can't think of this Riemann sum as summing the area of rectangles to approximate the area under the curve. Where f of c times delta x would give us area of a rectangle, where f of c would be the height of the rectangle, and delta x would be the width of the rectangle. If the function was negative, or dropped below the x-axis, we could use the same process, but it wouldn't represent the area because if the function is below the x-axis, the function value, or f of c, would be negative. Let's begin by setting up our partitions using 0, 2, 5, and 7. So here's x equals 0. Here's x equals 2, here's x equals 5, and here's x equals 7. Notice how using these four values, we have three partitions. This first partition has a width of 2, which would be delta x. Second partition has a width of 3, which would be delta x. And the third partition has a width of 2, which again would be delta x. Now we'll sketch our rectangles using the left endpoint of each partition. So for this first partition, f of 0 would be the height, and therefore this would be our rectangle. For the second partition, again using the left side, this would be the height of the rectangle. And for this third partition, again using the left side, this would be the height of the rectangle. Notice how the area of the rectangles would be less than the area under the curve and above the x-axis. But the value of this Riemann sum would be the sum of these three areas, or the area of this shaded region. Let's go ahead and set this up using function notation first. We have v equals, again, f of c times delta x. We're again using the left endpoint. We'd have f of 0 times delta x, which is 2 units. Plus, for the next rectangle, the height is, again, the left side, or f of 2, times delta x, which is 3, plus the height of the last rectangle would be f of 5, times delta x to the width, which is 2 units. For the next step, we'll determine the function values. So f of 0 would be 2 to the 0, that's going to be 1, plus 10, that's 11, so we have 11. Times 2 plus f of 2 would be 2 squared, that's 4, plus 10, that's going to be 14. So 14 times 3 plus f of 5 would be 2 to the 5th, that's 32, plus 10, that's 42, times 2. So we have 22 plus 42 plus 84. The value of this Riemann sum is 148. And if we were using this to approximate the area under the curve, again, this would not be a very good approximation because we can see there's a lot of area that's left out that's under the curve, but not part of the area of the rectangles. I hope you found this helpful.